So the quantum market has been one of the fastest growing markets in 2025 and into 2026. Today, we're going to go over IonQ. I'm actually going to a conference this upcoming week at CES. It's the Quantum Is Now, where they talk about the quantum tracks, including which companies are innovating. And some of the companies that will be there, I believe, will be IonQ. You got IonQ here. Q-Braid, we definitely see Inflection, which is a company that potentially could be going public very soon. So we'll be having some updates there, as a lot of times these conferences aren't covered very well, but have great insights. So we'll be there this week, I believe. As long as everything goes normal, we will be there. We got another year at CES here. So IonQ is now pulled back down from about $84 a share to $43 a share. So some people are calling it a deal. Now, the quantum computing company is focused on building their value through networks. And one thing that is kind of a misconception about quantum is that it runs solely on quantum, but you have the GPUs as well that are a key factor in making the company successful. And quantum computing, you can see, changing the world. And IonQ is leading the way across quantum computing, networking, sensing, and security. So the networking approach is interesting because in the last few months, we had Rigetti and IonQ and some others get inducted, you could say, into the program from NVIDIA that integrates quantum computers into data centers. And look at that, you got IonQ for powering space. They just had an agreement to deliver a 100 qubit system to South Korea. Here's another example. You can see them kind of working in tandem with GPUs to get the quantum computers running. And the developments that they've had have been pretty significant. You see, they're working with Amazon, Microsoft, Google Cloud, ORNL, Quantum, GE Research. And then they're also in many other areas with partners through not just the providing of services or their quantum computer through the cloud, but also allowing the people to use quantum for research. And it seems that a lot of their partners are in the research space. So when we think of these quantum networks, they're kind of like networks being deployed at many different areas from maybe adjacent to data centers, but also at universities. They're based out of Maryland, and they work with a lot of companies in that area in operating quantum technology to accelerate drug development, accelerate the material science, whether it's battery optimization, or it could be quantum computer calculations of many different data points or something like that, to take that data and come up with chemically or chemistry based, but could be atomic level answers for material science or chemical reactions or chemistry in general, that will allow human beings to essentially, let's say, regenerate their cells, or to have cures for different diseases, or in some cases scrub CO2 from the air. Those are some of the things that I've heard from the IonQ approach. Now, IonQ is getting a lot of hype articles, obviously. You see, to the moon or crash landing, there's always these hype stocks, but hype articles. But ultimately, they've built a market cap now to about $16 billion. If you look back on the chart as well, it's been pretty gradual. Well, it's been very exciting to see them get up to $84 a share. Most of the time when they've made these large runs up into levels around $50 or somewhere in here, they've pulled back down into these $20 ranges or back down in these $34 ranges, and pulled pretty consistently into the previous rising support level. You kind of see that here. They got this level here. They're at the 200-day moving average. So if I just get rid of all the drawings, the green line is going to be that 200-day moving average. And oftentimes, if it's holding above, it's bullish, and you can see them doing that here. And if it's above and it's above the blue line, this EMA, it's really bullish. But right now it's still kind of struggling. It's been holding below that EMA, the exponential moving average, and then just hopefully not crossing below the 200-day, because then we'd see a pretty large break in pattern. And then we could potentially see sell downs into that $35 range or lower to $18. From a technical perspective, that could make sense if they don't hold this level. Now, if they hold this level, we're looking fairly bullish. This is a previous consolidation zone where they could use it as a support, and right at the 200-day moving average, that would be great. They're at $45 a share. So as a long-term holder, I would hope they, you know, bounce, continue up. But also as a long-term holder, you know, you got to be okay, even if they pull down, because this is a long-term stock. Why is it a long-term stock? Well, currently the financials don't really match the market cap, but the market cap is driven by what could be with quantum. So there's a reason that, you know, Amazon and Google and Microsoft are all working with IonQ. It's because the IonQ technology, if you have quantum computers that could calculate, let's say, things that GPUs would take years to calculate, now you can run an entire data center type of computation from a huge data center, you know, and that just makes up, you know, one fraction of the computation that a quantum computer could do. And so, you know, it's just the potential for quantum has been very clear, but the commercial usage, not only do they have to have huge problems to solve, but they also have to be monetizable in a way that will increase their revenue more. Now, they did have a lot more revenue than most would anticipate. They're actually up 200% year over year with it. Revenue up to $40 million in the last quarter, but they managed to actually spend more than $1 billion, the net income of negative $1 billion. Those types of numbers make you kind of worried because, you know, before that, the most I'd see in a negative net income year or quarter would be around $200 million or something like that. But looking at the quarter or year over year or quarter over quarter growth, excuse me, if their assets are at $4 billion, but they're going through, you know, $1 billion in negative net income per quarter, like in theory, you know, they could go out of business in a year with that type of cash burn. But they managed to, while having that big negative net income, still increase their total assets to $4.3 billion. As long as they don't have more of those $1 billion negatives, you could see them continue to stay healthy in the long term. But nevertheless, you know, $4 billion in assets, that's a lot of cash. Obviously, they got a lot of investments. You see NVIDIA investing in them and many others, but it's still not justifying their current market cap from a financial perspective, because that's $16 billion, which is kind of an insane PE ratio right now. So when we're looking at the chart, this is how it looks. I could expect they might not hold this level. They might sell down further, but I want to get some more insights at this conference. As I mentioned, it's really important that we do that. The US is investing more in quantum. You see this $2.7 billion quantum initiative from the US. That's been in the conversation. There's a lot more growth in quantum usage over the last few quarters. In fact, we've even started integrating quantum into our analysis. So for example, if I'm, you know, analyzing a stock, I can actually use IonQ. We've added IonQ quantum backend here, and I can get the quantum analysis. So basically, what you're looking at here is a projection over the next 1 month, and we have projections from many different time frames while using Grok, an AI model. So an AI model gives us a projection. Every projection for each time frame has a confidence score. We then give those confidence scores, all of them, to the quantum analysis, in this case IonQ. Then IonQ selects the one that it believes is most likely to occur. So we're using it in financial analysis and tech. It's been very powerful. Been using it quite often as it's really been optimizing my investing. Kind of helps me with my decisions, and I can use Rigetti as well. So we are starting to integrate quantum technology and how simulators are deployed. And if you go and you might wonder, you know, how would you use quantum? So if you're on IonQ and you go down to we're getting in the weeds here a little bit, but you go down to their partners. So for example, their customers here, you got Hyundai. I'm going to wait for it to show Amazon, or maybe I can just search it. Might be faster than waiting. Yeah, let me just search it. So let's just search bracket. Amazon bracket offers the ability for you to use Quantum through the cloud. So see, you got IonQ or Rigetti. Okay, now it takes a pretty high level, I guess, technical ability, right? Because you have to be able to integrate with the Quantum, with the data and everything else. And I'm not really an algorithmic trader. We usually trade based and invest based on value and opportunities and market movements, as well as where the value is going with the companies. But algorithmically, it can be really interesting to explore as well. And we're starting to see some results. So anyway, this is kind of where you would tap into IonQ through the cloud. Currently, I would say they're a little overvalued. It would make sense they sell down. From a chart perspective, it also actually could make sense if they don't hold here, they would sell down further. But that if they hold here, they might actually jump back up to $50 to $60 a share from a technical perspective, because that's really been their trend. But let's not forget, you know, they sold down massively around $50 down to $19 last year. So you got to have some careful risk management. If you're in a shorter term trade, probably looking for, you know, managing risk somewhere around this $43 range and looking for a recovery, something like this, about a 10 to 20% increase. But in the near term, watching that level here around 45 will be what we're doing. We may actually even trade it this week. I think it would be really nice to get some good insights at the conference, as well as make a decision to potentially invest in it if the opportunity presents itself. We'll be there at market open. If you'd like to tune on into our daily live trading sessions, we're there Monday through Friday at market open. It's the second link in the description to watch me trade live. You get to see my entries and my exits, and you even get a free t-shirt when you join StockMate in the second link below. By earning your thumbs up, hit the like button, do consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.